AI can play chess. Today, AI can make a machine lift its arms, can create a robot. But can AI ever understand a six-year-old's story that a child makes up?
The biggest risk that we face as a civilization is artificial intelligence.
And we have a bias towards human intelligence because that's where our notion of intelligence comes from.
Yeah. If you talk about the artificial intelligence itself, right? The goal is to sort of like develop human level of intelligence.
Ultimately, we have to realize that intelligence is just a term. Each person is free to use the term as they feel like.
The term artificial intelligence, I feel, is often misunderstood. You know, we have this image from science fiction movies of these robotic machines going and destroying humanity.
Pehli assumption ye hai ki hum sochte hain ki agar koi artificial intelligence system wo same kaam kar sakta hai jo hum kar pate hain, to uska matlab hai wo baki sab bhi kar lega jo hum kar pate hain.
When I say intelligence, I may have certain things in my mind. जब तुम intelligence बोलते हो तो तुम्हारे दिमाग में कुछ certain notions होंगी. तो there is a wide variety here. But कुछ common features हैं जो I think जिसमें हम agree कर सकते हैं कि intelligence में ये होती हैं. One is कि to understand new information. Then to learn new information. और उस नई information को then to use that new information in a different context.
How many problems have I solved? And out of those problems, how many new ideas have I generated and how many new solutions have I created? Honestly, I believe no amount of artificial intelligence can discover that. There is a lot of human intelligence that is required.
I see it very differently. I think artificial intelligence is essentially enhancing human abilities and can help us in many ways. And one of the areas that I do like to talk about that we're very passionate about is this whole field of autonomous driving.
So we are Ati Motors, Ati as in the Hindi or Sanskrit Ati, right? So Ati Sundar, Ati Vashisht. Okay, so that's what we are, making a autonomous electric cargo vehicle.
I think Tesla is trying to ask whether they can create an environment where drivers are assisted by modern technologies. What we are trying to do is to design an autonomous vehicle, where in our vehicle there is no place for even a driver. So there is no cubicle where a driver can sit. So it has to be purely autonomous. It's robotic in that sense.
You want to redefine what a vehicle is, because now that you have autonomy, you don't need to design the vehicle to have forward-facing glass or any other thing.
So our challenges are different because we have to design the vehicle ground up.
You can do the full maneuver here.
So full forward and reverse.
Yeah.
And cargo was a very interesting space because in cargo you can have a completely unmanned vehicle, so a lot of safety things become easier to handle as well, and then we started thinking about what topology could we have. So it's a neat arrangement because you only have two wheels, they do not turn, so your mechanical complexity is reduced, but you have more control because you can do this in-place turn. Driverless cars are just a start. You can have robots that do, you'll first of all have robots doing almost everything. So right now we are starting with transportation, and then they can actually start, and they already do manufacturing. And at some point all this will come together where you can actually have a supply chain where you can say that this is a part that's made completely by robots.
कमाई उतना नहीं होता है बाबू वही 200-300 रुपया हो जाता है यहाँ इतना बैटरी गाड़ी निकल गया है जो हम लोग के खाने के लिए सोचना पड़ता है एक भी पैसेंजर आता है उस पर ही हावी हो जाता है चार चार गाड़ी
रखे हुए कैसे चल रहा है दाल रोटी, अब कोई बैठता ही नहीं, ऑटो बैटरी गाड़ी का कौन बैठेगा,
जल्दी भागता है लोग,
सब जल्दी भागता है सर।
अब तो संकट हो गई, अब बैटरी गाड़ी हो गई तो क्या,
बैटरी से समस्या हो रही है।
अब बैटरी वाला है तो बैटरी वाला उतना पैसे नहीं कि हम लोग ले पाए, 1,00,000 रुपया लगता है डेवलप।
मशीन का उतना ही उपयोग करें जो आपको सुविधा दे। ये जो पूरी दुनिया में और थर्ड वर्ल्ड में ऑटोमेशन हो रहा है, ये मानवता के खिलाफ है। जैसे मान लीजिए कि देश भर में 2,00,000 कारें हैं, 2,00,000 ड्राइवर हैं, कोई चलाता है, मालिक चलाता है या वो चलाता है, लेकिन यहाँ पे तो कोई काम ही नहीं है आपके पास, तो आखिर उस बचे हुए समय में क्या करने वाले हैं आप? दूसरा कि जिनको आप रिप्लेस करेंगे वो क्या करेगा? अगर वो भूखा है, भूखा सो रहा है, और उसका संवैधानिक अधिकार है इस देश में, सरकार का काम है कि उसको रोजी रोटी देना, उसको स्वास्थ्य का देखरेख करना, वो नहीं होगा तो इससे क्या होने वाला है? इससे तो लोग उबाल हो पे आएगा।
तो एक कार्यक्रम है 8 तारीख को, अभी हम आपको इनविटेशन कार्ड भी उसका दे देंगे, आमंत्रण पत्र दे देंगे, और ये कार्यक्रम है कि साइकिल रिक्शा से जुड़ी हुई क्या समस्याएं हैं और वो समस्याओं को कैसे हटाया जाए, सरकार से कैसे इसको मांगा जाए।
Every time a new technology has come in, I think people have rebelled against it. When cars came in, I'm sure there were a bunch of guys belonging to the Horse Carriage Association who said, we will not allow cars.
I mean, imagine, for example, carrying nuclear waste. I mean, you don't want people doing it, right? I mean, it is better for an autonomous vehicle to be carrying nuclear waste, right? Or for hazardous, like industrial environments where accidents, etc. are very dangerous. It's much better for autonomous vehicles to be moving stuff. So I think initially they will just bring in much more safety.
The benefit that you have with a machine is, even though its intelligence definitely is not at the level of human intelligence, it doesn't feel sleepy, it's not distracted, it doesn't suffer from road rage. And maybe someone needs to do an analysis, how many of the accidents are really because of that and not really just poor human judgment.
I mean, India has the highest number of accidents, by the way, right, in the world, in terms of numbers. I think that will reduce.
It's about 140,000 deaths a year in India, over 1 million globally. The economic cost, for instance, in the US is estimated to be $1 trillion a year. You know, India people don't have good estimates, but I've heard some estimates as high as $100 billion a year just due to road safety related issues, right? And so that's, I think eventually people will kind of realize, okay, now I have a vehicle that offers me all of these benefits. It's always alert, no matter what time of the day or night I'm driving. And if someone cuts it off, it'll stop and not get into an argument and a fight.
Every economy will undergo change, which means that certain older types of doing things will get displaced. I think that's inevitable.
And a lot of technology transitions actually face resistance, but over time, once people realize that there can be more benefits, and there's always pros and cons to each technology, people start accepting it.
देखिए वो जो पुरानी जो तर्क है ना वो फिट नहीं बैठता, क्योंकि जो पुराना ऑटोमेशन होता था और जो नया ऑटोमेशन, उसमें बहुत अंतर है। कौन सा मशीन आदमी के लिए मैंने सुविधाजनक हो सकता है और कौन सा मशीन आदमी के लिए नाशकारी हो सकता है, ये दो अलग अलग संदर्भ है। फिर तो ऐसा कहेंगे किताब आई थी तो भी लोग विरोध किए थे, ऐसा मामला है नहीं। जो लोगों को विकास में, सामूहिक विकास में मदद करे, वो तकनीक फायदेमंद है।
आई थिंक इट इज For autonomy to go into the real world is a very long roadmap, I think, in India, especially in India. Some people think, by the way, it is too long also, in the sense it will not happen because the roads are too chaotic, etc. I mean, on roads you need, in India you need social negotiation, etc. to be done.
Autonomous driving, there are multiple levels of autonomy. And again, we should not confuse autonomous driving with driverless cars. To me, they are not exactly the same thing. You have level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3. Level 5 autonomy is when you replace the driver and the cars drive themselves across all environments, all conditions. But we're so far away from it, especially if you look at the driving conditions in India, I don't really spend too much time thinking about it.
I mean, 5,000-year-old lifestyle to 21st century lifestyle coexisting in India. And I think that coexistence will keep happening. There will be places where, but But the thing is, yeah, the older stuff, as you can see, it will keep getting reduced, but at a very slow pace. So I think, unlike Western countries, in India, the transition cost per se is not very high because the transition is never rapid. So it's not coming tomorrow.
So, like, I had been interested in this problem like since 2009, since January 2009, right? So that was like first time I learned about this DARPA Urban Challenge, DARPA Urban Grand Challenges, right? That happened in the US. So that those videos, especially like one of the videos by the team MIT, right? I saw that video in January 2009, and that's when basically this problem of like cell ranks sort of like fascinated me. So I decided, okay, why not give it a try? Like, try to develop autonomous navigation technology that can run a vehicle on a highway or in at least in some road in India, right? So that's how sort of like started working on this problem. And after started working, I sort of never looked back. So these are the various controllers that we installed. Actually, this is the accelerator control, this brake control. If we talk about solving the cell rank in India, right, we have to develop some really complex AI system, right, that understands, okay, what road is, what traffic is, what the movement of people is, where they are going to be, like, let's say 5 seconds from now, to be able to map all those things, to be able to make all those projections, all those predictions. This is a really hard problem, right? For example, previous CEO of Uber said that India would be the last country to get self-driving vehicles. I mean, it's fine. So basically, they're looking at their tech and they're saying, okay, we understand our tech is not ready to work in India, right?
Yeah.
But that's what the challenge is. I mean, can you develop the tech or not to work in this kind of environment, right? So we are working on tech that works in India.